The next name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will be looking at is the name Al-Jawad. Al-Jawad, the generous. This name, Al-Jawad, occurs in the Sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ جَوَادٌ يُحِبُّ الْجُودِ. That indeed Allah, the Majestic, the Sublime, He is Jawad, He is generous. يُحِبُّ الْجُودِ, He loves generosity. And He is generous Himself, and He loves to give, and He loves the act of giving. So when His slaves give, they are generous, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves that in His slaves. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Jawad, and this name is mentioned in the Sunnah. Now, Al-Jawad is the one who does jud, right? So what is jud? Jud is gracious giving, okay? Meaning it is to give, not just to give, but to give generously, to give a lot, and to give without being asked, before being asked. Why? So that the other does not have to experience the humility of begging. So for example, you see someone who is clearly thirsty, right? So don't just wait for them to ask you for water. You go and get water for them. This is jud. Why? How is it jud? Because you didn't wait for them to ask you. You saw the need, you recognized it, and you got up and you fulfilled the need. And a person or someone who is generous in this way, then they're not just generous once in a while. They're actually extremely generous, and they're generous in many ways. So this is why jud is extreme generosity. It is gracious giving. So you see, for example, if you're only giving when you're asked, then what does that mean? You will give rarely. But when you give without being asked, this means that you're always looking for opportunities to give and to benefit people, right? So remember that if one gives when asked, that is karam. But when a person gives, when someone gives without being asked, that is jud. Okay? And in the Arabic language, we see the jad al-matar. Matar, rain, when the verb jada is used to describe rain, it is when rain has been abundant, or rain that was basically heaviest rain possible. And you cannot imagine a rain that would be more abundant than that particular rain. Yani it's the heaviest rain possible. Okay, when jud is used for a horse, it is a horse that runs really fast, such that it outstrips others. Okay, that it always gets ahead of others. So this is the meaning of jud. It is generosity. It is to be extremely generous, to outstrip others, to be generous, yani to the max, beyond which yani you cannot even imagine, or basically more than what you can imagine, more than what you can expect, and it is to give without being asked. So this is the concept of jud. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves jud. He is jawad. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is jawad, it means that first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's generosity is greater than any generosity imagined or combined together. Think about the generosity of people. Some people, mashallah, they're very generous, always looking for opportunities to benefit others, to give others. Some acts of generosity, you're moved to tears because of them. Some acts of generosity, they're so beautiful. And we see different forms of generosity, right? So combine all acts of generosity from people, all of that, yani it's not even a speck, okay, compared to the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because His generosity is immeasurable, because there is no one except that they benefit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's jud, right? Yani consider how long the skies and the earth have been in existence. Consider how many creatures Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spread over the land and the sea, in the depths of the ocean, in the depths of the earth, on the surface of the earth, all parts of the world. And how many creatures Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created and spread just on the earth. How many there were before, how many there are now, and how many there will be in the future. Allahu Akbar. And every single creature, every single moment is benefiting from the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His generosity is immeasurable. Immeasurable. And this means that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jawad, He is way too generous. Way too generous. More than we can even imagine. And you consider the fact that when people disobey Allah, He lets them sleep in the night as if they never disobeyed Him. He lets them enjoy good food, and He lets them enjoy the good things of the world as if they had never sinned. He continues to protect them. He continues to provide them. He continues to maintain them. He answers them when they ask Him. He accepts them when they repent to Him. Could we ever fathom His generosity? It is beyond our imagination. And then we see that when people are generous, even when creatures are generous to one another, this is also because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He inspires generosity to His creatures. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jawad, it means that He loves to give. And when He loves to give, when people do not ask Him, or when they feel that, you know, it's beneath them to ask Him, then this is something that angers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in a hadith we learn that لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهَ يَغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ, that whoever does not ask Allah, then Allah becomes angry with him. Allah is angry with him, that how dare you not ask Allah? What do you think? He's not going to give you? What do you think? He doesn't have enough? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves to give, which means that we better ask Him. And remember that His treasures do not diminish by giving to His servants. And one more thing we should remember is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jawad, He is truly, He is extremely generous. Sometimes people wonder that how come Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not give me then when I ask Him? How come, I've been making dua for such and such thing for so long and I still don't have it? If Allah is generous, then how come I am deprived of His generosity? No, correct your way of thinking. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala withholds something from a slave, then that does not contradict His generosity. Because first of all, it is not that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you nothing. You are failing to recognize the gifts that Allah has given you, the huge favors that Allah has given you, right? Because it's not that Allah has given you nothing. He has given you a lot, but you're just focused on what you don't have, right? What others have been given, and you are neglecting and completely overlooking everything else that Allah has given you. So His withholding does not contradict His generosity. And besides, when He withholds, when He does not give you something, then He decides to do that. This is His decision to not give you something at a certain point. And that decision is based on His wisdom. It is based on His knowledge, because He knows what to give to whom, at what time, in what amount, at which place. So trust His decision. Remember that His withholding does not contradict His generosity. So what are we supposed to do when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jawad? Of course, this means that we should realize His gifts. We should believe that He is more generous than what I think He is. You see, sometimes shaitan, in the Quran also we learn that shaitan said that وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ, that you will not find most of them to be grateful. And most of the children of Adam will not be grateful. So shaitan makes us focus on what is missing. Shaitan makes us focus on what we don't have. He makes us think negatively about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about Adam alayhi salam and Hawa. They were in Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given them so much in Jannah and had given them so much freedom, right? That eat freely from whatever that you want, right? من حيث شئتم, من حيث شئتما, رغدا من حيث شئتما, freely from wherever that you want. Meaning, eat as much as you want, from wherever that you want, don't have any hesitation, yani, all of this is for you. However, there was one restriction, one limitation. وَلَا تَقْرَبَ هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ Don't go near this particular tree. That's it, just one tree. Everything else, you got it. You can enjoy it without limit, without any restriction. But just one tree, you cannot have. And what did Shaytan do? Shaytan told them to eat from that particular tree. And he told them that the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told you not to eat from that tree is because if you eat from it, you will become angels and you will become immortals. So he made them focus on what they were not supposed to have, on what was not given to them. And this is what Shaytan does to us as well, right? That out of all the millions of blessings that Allah has given us, and he makes us forget about all of them and just keep thinking about what is missing. So this line of thinking is from who? It is inspired by Shaytan. So remind yourself that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been extremely generous to me, ever generous to me, over and over. And if I feel that Allah has not given me something, yani I shouldn't think like this. Because the fact is that Allah has given me a lot. And remember, earlier we learned that even when He withholds something from you, in fact, He is giving you something. Because when He withholds something from you, you get the opportunity to be patient, right? And with that patience, what do you get? A lot of reward. We focus only on the present. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for us forever, right? So we focus only on the now. That's why we become greedy for things right now. And we don't want to be patient. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala withholds certain things for us, that is an opportunity for us to be patient so that we can have endless reward in the future. And also, through depriving us, He gives us certain other things. So realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ever generous. Recognize His gifts. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-jawad, we see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that yuhibbul jud, He loves generosity, meaning He loves to give, so ask Him. And He loves giving, which means that we should also give. We should also be generous. He loves jud. So give how, when, give before being asked. Don't wait to be asked by others. What, you know, notice, observe, and put yourself in the shoes of other people and see that if I were here, what would I need, right? If I were in a position like that, what would be convenient for me? Save people the embarrassment of asking. Don't wait to be asked. And also this means that give more than what you think people deserve. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was ajwadun nas, the most generous of all people. Right? Which means that he gave so much to people. And sometimes, you know, we start measuring that, you know what, this person has only, you know, been good to me in this and that way. So this much of a gift is enough for them. Right? I don't need to give them a better gift than this. No, give people more than what you think they deserve. And how is it that we can be generous? We can be generous in a number of ways. We can be generous by being of service and help to others, and begin at home. Don't just wait to, you know, earn your degree in nonprofit so that you can work with a nonprofit organization so that you can make an impact in the world. Any, that's excellent, mashallah. That's your long-term dream. But begin where you are, at home. See how you can be of service to people. How is it that you can benefit them? How is it that you can show generosity? And sometimes that can be simply by putting someone else's dishes away as soon as they're done eating, right? They can do that themselves, or they can ask you to put their dishes away. But why not? You're standing right next to them. They're still sitting. They're done eating. Their dishes are right in front of them. You could pick them up and take them away. Don't wait to be asked by, you know, people at home to do certain things, right? To fill gas in the car, to throw the garbage out, to vacuum. You know, these are simple, basic things. But it's a whole lifestyle. It's a whole mindset. So adopt the mindset of generosity, of giving, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the act of giving. And then be generous with the position that Allah has given you, whether it is, you know, your status, your age, your money, you know, your connections, whatever privileges Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, use them to be of benefit to people. Be generous with your time. Be generous with your knowledge. Be generous with your limbs, meaning use this body to help people. Use your hands. Use your physical strength. MashaAllah, you know, some men, so much strength in their bodies, but they're sitting down on, you know, with their phones and their wives, subhanAllah, going up and down, doing laundry, carrying children, cooking, cleaning, constantly doing physical work. And mashallah, people who are so able-bodied are just sitting, relaxing, chilling. Yani, okay, fine, you are bringing money home and you expect that your wife works at home. But that doesn't mean that when you're at home, you do nothing. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, what was his way when he was at home? He would be in the service of his family. He would be in the service of his family. He would be helping his family. SubhanAllah, any heavy dishes, women are cooking in them, cleaning them, washing them. These dishes are big, you know, heavy to carry. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you strong arms, don't just flex them and take, you know, selfies and post them online. No, use those muscles to help someone in need. And that could be your own sister, your own mother, your own wife who is struggling with, you know, carrying heavy dishes, for example. What good is this body if you're not using it in showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And gratitude is not just by, you know, saying alhamdulillah. Gratitude is also with action. Amal. I'malu ala Dawood shukra. Work in thankfulness. Right? So do something in thankfulness. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the ability to see, to listen, to type fast, or to download things, etc. Whatever skills Allah has given you, whatever ability Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, use that to show generosity to people. And then part of generosity is also to be patient with people, to show pardon, to be tolerant, to exhibit gracious manners, good manners. All of this is part of Jude. So show generosity. And we learned that as long as a person is, you know, helping people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also helps him. So show generosity so that you can receive generous gifts from Allah azza wa jal.